strategies. Well, we have been trying to touch base with a lot of stakeholders of the economy to find out what the impact of demonetization has been. There is some relief in the NBFC space, at least that's what players like Bharat Financial have told us. But let's find out what's happening in the north. HP Singh, the founder and MD of Satin Credit Care, joins us now to give us a check on the situation there. Mr. Singh, good morning. Yesterday, Bharat Financial Inclusion told us that disbursements have picked up slightly in the last 1 week or so, and the situation is not as bad now as it was in the week post November 8th. How is the situation up in the north?
Good morning, sir. I think in the north also it's the same phenomenon. The elections have started picking up post the demonetization, and in states, even in MP, Rajasthan, Punjab and Haryana, including some parts of UP, basically the collections have started picking up. So it's much better as the currency supply, I think, increases across in the rural spaces. I think it'll start getting better and better. So it's somewhat better than the previous week, you know, from now on.
Mr. Singh, good morning. Thanks for joining. An analyst was telling us that unless MFIs get 98% of their collections going, the business can be disrupted. Is that a fair number, and when do you expect collections to reach that level?
I think if you look at the previous history, 98% has been there with us for a fairly long time because of the strength of the business model. But this has been a very different kind of a disruption. So I think, you know, probably reaching 98% is still some while away. The point which I would like to make is that it is not the intent which is actually hurting. It's in fact the supply of the currency which is really hurting. And in terms of also disruption in their economic activity, because, you know, they're probably, you know, today standing in the queue, the line from the banks to get their currency back. So I think that is the reason why it's hurting, and that's why the reason why the collections are low. So I think 98% as a benchmark technically will be some time away, but I think that's probably not the right figure which we are really looking at. In our sense, I think 60-70%, even if it's come up till this level right now, is fairly good enough for this industry, which is very, very cash intensive.
Okay. Mr. Singh, good morning. But, you know, for SMEs and MSMEs, and I presume that you'll deal with a lot of them, is there going to be a prolonged pain over the next 1 or 2 years?
SME, because we deal with microfinance technically, and the installments are very, very less in their repayment as probably an SME would be. But yes, they all are also into some economic activity. So I think it will going to be some while. I think not maybe about a year or so, but I think maybe in the next couple of months it's going to be a little impacted to a certain. It'll be impacted in the next couple of months, but I think it's surely going to pick on because the installment amounts are pretty less, you know, in terms of microfinance. So I think, you know, it'll probably have a far more a better ratio in terms of the repayment as compared to larger ticket size and larger amounts for SMEs and the